Let's Go and talk about Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Pokemon Let's Go Eevee and this little thing here that I've been flashing around here. This is the Pokeball Plus that Nintendo sent out to me to play Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu. I didn't play Pokemon Let's Go Eevee. I only got the Pikachu varietal. And this is a different kind of take for the Pokemon video game universe, and I think you guys are all pretty much aware. It's kind of like a hybrid of a lot of the mechanics and a lot of the accessibility that we've seen in Pokemon Go, the mobile phenomenon, which we all still have on our phones. I don't know how many of you are still playing Pokemon Go, but they keep, Niantic and the Pokemon Company keep adding new content and enhancing that experience out there. So clearly there are still millions of players of Pokemon Go out there. Well, Nintendo and the Pokemon Company realized that there was an opportunity on Nintendo Switch to build something that is going to bridge the gap between the traditional Pokemon RPG experience and, the sort of throw the ball at the screen kind of experience that you get in Pokemon Go. And so Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu is sort of the answer to that. And I gotta tell you, I was a little bit concerned that it was gonna be just sort of more gimmicky and it was more gonna be focused about selling this very slick peripheral. But there is a tremendous amount of depth and detail and joy and beauty in this game, and I've been having a blast playing this sucker. It's a big title. There's lots to see, there's lots to explore. If you have grown up with Pokemon games, you're gonna recognize that this is the Kanto version of, or the Kanto area in the Pokemon universe, so it's the stuff that we saw in Pokemon Red, Blue, and Yellow. A lot of the same cities, a lot of the same towns, same kinds of setups, but those were all on, Game Boy screens. So it's a very different thing to see all of this rendered and embellished and put into 3D on a television screen, and to be able to run around in 3D and see the scale and the size of the different Pokemon creatures. It's really, really lovely. And of course you get into all kinds of conversations with the citizens of the region, and they send you off on missions, and there's lots of fights that you get into, Poke battles, and then you're also, fighting the leaders of the gyms that you're gonna run into along the way. And you're collecting Pokemon like crazy, and the way that they've done the collection of the Pokemon is very much like Pokemon Go. Instead of flicking on your screen, you actually pick up a Joy-Con controller off the side of the Switch, or you can have it all connected to the Switch and play it sort of more traditionally like that as well. But it's really fun to add this mechanic of actually, pretending to toss a controller or the Pokeball Plus, if you go for it, at the screen. And the thing that they've added to this little device is you have some pretty cool haptic feedback, some feedback of the Pokeball, vibrating as it captures a Pokemon. There's also a light built into here, so it lights up and you can hear the sounds of the Pokemon creature inside the Pokeball. And it adds this kind of visceral, little juice to the experience, which makes it really fun. The thing that I really could experience and really could see of my experience of playing the game is that I had a smile on my face. It was very light. It was very easy. I'm coming off of Red Dead Redemption 2, and if there was a game that was so 100% in the opposite direction from Red Dead Redemption 2 and its bleakness and, its really heavy themes, it's sort of like this cute adventure, this role-playing experience where everyone is obsessed with collecting these little creatures, and it's just joyful, Even when you're battling some of the Team Rocket people and they're kind of jerks and they're trying to steal your Pokemon and they're trying to catch them all and do some nefarious things, it's still lighthearted, it's still fun, it's still really, cute. And seeing all of the 3D renders of all the Poke creatures is just really, really fun. And I found myself completely engaged. I played it in co-op as well with my daughter, and all you had to do was pick up one of the Joy-Con and shake it, and your character pops in, and then you can collect things together. And you actually get some bonuses if you throw the Pokeball at the same time, which was pretty cool to see. I played that with my kid, but I also played it with some adult friends, and we had smiles on our faces, and we were high-fiving, and I could just appreciate the transport of joy that this game was offering. And I played it also in a bunch of different ways. I played it sort of Joy-Con attached in a sort of more traditional portable experience, and the fidelity of a portable Pokemon sort of at the console quality on the screen was really terrific. It felt super indulgent. But I also took the Joy-Con off, and I was had it set up on a on an airplane tray table, and was flicking and catching Pokemon that way. I had it plugged into a hotel screen, so I was playing it on the big screen as well, and it just looked. It looks sensational. Honestly, it just looked like, wow, this huge world is open for us. And there's so much to see and so many different ways to go. And, you know, there's lots of little clever touches, too. You'll find books and you'll find school rooms and classrooms. And, you know, people will say, and this Pokemon is too much for me, but you've caught 75 different Pokemon already. Will you take care of my little creature? And then you add that to your roster. And if you pick this thing up, actually, you get a Mew that's embedded inside of this. And you can download it into the game. And this thing also works with Pokemon Go, the mobile experience, so you can actually hook it up to the Pokemon Go app and take it outside and do the catching the Pokemon that way. You can put a Pokemon into this thing and take it out for a walk and it will level up. You can also take the Poke creatures out and they can walk around with you and follow you and Pikachu. I had Pikachu on my shoulder. You can also interact with Pikachu so that he falls in love with you a little bit, which is really sweet. You feed him little fruits and you're patting him on the head, and you know, you could dress up Pikachu in the outfits that you collect, and so you can sort of coordinate with each other. It's just darn cute, and it really does charm you. And I think in some ways that is even a little bit more accessible than some of the other Pokemon titles that have come out before, which are definitely super attractive and super, you can see the cleverness and you can see why people get obsessed with collecting all of them when you're talking about the 2D, mostly portable games, although the 3DS stuff has been a little bit more 3D, but they've been somewhat, even though there's online trading and competitive elements and all kinds of stuff, they felt a little bit sort of like the game is one-to-one with a person, but this one feels like, especially because you can throw it up on the TV and you can bring a family or a group of people around the experience. It does feel like it pulls people in. Partially, I think, because Pokemon Go has done such a huge job at explaining the phenomenon of Pokemon to so many different people out there. And I think this is a nice bridge. This is a bridge game, you know, to the granularity that exists in the hardcore Pokemon RPGs out there. It doesn't offer that. You're not really having to level up every single individual Pokemon creature. Your whole team levels up after battles and after you capture different Pokemon along the way. You can trade the ones back that you don't need to Professor Oak, and then Professor Oak will give you some candy, and you can feed some of the candy to the Pokemon that you want to level up to, you know, increase their stats or to get them to a higher level count or whatever you want to do that way. But it isn't as, you know, strategic. It isn't as sort of micromanage-y as some of the other Pokemon games, which I think can be a little bit overwhelming for a lot of people as well. This is almost like an onboard experience to kind of get you moving in that direction, which presumably will be what the Pokemon Company and Nintendo provide for the Switch next year. But I have to tell you, I've been super impressed. This is a very fun game. It's a fun game to play with someone smaller than you, as maybe their first Pokemon experience. But even if you've played Pokemon games for a long time, I think it's kind of refreshing to see it all rendered like this and to see it, celebrated in a way. You know, this is a really, really fun and very cool experience, and I've been very happy to escape into the world of Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu. I'm going to give it an 8.5 out of 10. And I have to tell you, out of all the different ways that I played Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu, this was the way that I preferred to play it. I loved playing with the Pokeball Plus. Yes, I felt a little like I'm trying to be Steve Buscemi in that, what are you guys all talking about, kids gif that out there, that meme that's out there? But it's still super fun to play the game, and it really adds another layer of escapism into this thing.